go ahead and get started. Good morning. I am so pleased to be here at the Ron Pearson Center as the Unite for Ukraine meal packaging event gets underway. I want to thank Hy-Vee for their generous sponsorship and Meals from the Heartland for the incredible work that they do feeding the hungry across the globe wherever there's a need. And right now, one of Ukraine's most pressing needs is sustaining its food supply. As the brutal war enters its third month, attacks are becoming more widespread and more devastating with each passing week. Once thriving cities are barely recognizable, survivors are without the most basic necessities for daily life. And it's been reported that more than 6 million Ukrainians are now displaced within the country, and 5 million have fled to other countries for refuge. As the world watches these heartbreaking developments unfold every day in real time, we desperately want to find ways to help. 4 weeks ago, I was joined by a number of Ukrainian Iowans, state government leaders, and law enforcement officers to send a shipment of helmets and ballistic vests to our sister state in Cherkasy in central Ukraine. And I'm pleased to report that these items and other supplies were shipped to Ukraine last week. And just 1 week after our donation of protective equipment left Iowa, I had the pleasure of visiting Meals from the Heartland in West Des Moines to see 4 pallets containing 30,000 meals loaded into a truck for delivery to New Jersey, where they were later flown overseas. I want to thank X-Guard Industries, a manufacturing company for the freight industry based right here in Des Moines, for their generous donation to Iowa sister states, which made it possible to quickly transport the meals to Ukraine. Last week, we learned that the meals had arrived in Poland, and today I'm pleased to report that they're in transit for delivery to Ukraine. These donations were in direct response to requests from Cherkasy's officials for items that they urgently needed. So as the war stretches on, the extent of need in Ukraine is dramatically increasing, and it must be addressed now to avoid the humanitarian crisis. And that's what today's event is all about. Unite for Ukraine is the first Meals from the Heartland public packaging event to provide additional aid to Ukraine. And again, I want to thank Hy-Vee for sponsoring the event with a $50,000 donation that covers the cost of the ingredients being packaged here today. By the end of the last shift, our goal is to have packaged a total of 300,000 meals, which will then begin the journey to Ukraine early next week. And now I'd like to invite Randy Edeker, CEO of Hy-Vee, to say a few words about today's event.
Well, thank you all for being here. I want to thank the government for thinking of Hy-Vee and asking us to be a part of this event. Obviously, we are very focused on food insecurity right here in our own country. We started our Food Bank Fridays trying to bolster the amount of food out of our food banks. We think that there's going to be a real need for food in our food banks. We've had a long-time partnership with Meals from the Heartland. I just got updated numbers that we've provided 16 million meals through Meals for the Heartland through the sale of our box of cereal. Every box of cereal feeds a child. And so that's been important for us and a big deal for us for many, many years. And so when we got the call to be here today, this is an easy decision. I mean, it's $50,000 in the big scheme of things. When you look at these meals going, it's the least that we can do. So we appreciate all of our folks who volunteered their time last night to be here. We packed 50,000 meals last night. 250,000 meals will be packed today. They'll be working until 8 o'clock tonight to get those done. And really, these folks they're the ones that make it happen. So thanks.
Very much. And in addition to the generous donation, I want to thank you for opening up the conference center. This is a perfect place to package the meals, so thank you for doing that as well. Of course, none of this is possible without Meals from the Heartland. It's an organization that we're so very fortunate to have right here in Iowa. I have long been a fan of this faith-based organization that builds its mission really around the importance of prayer, volunteerism, and financial giving to support starving children worldwide. And that includes Iowa communities and across the United States. So here to share more about how Meals from the Heartland is working to help sustain the food supply in Ukraine is its executive director, Greg DeHite.
I want to start by thanking Governor Reynolds and Heidi for partnering with Meals from the Heartland and the hundreds of volunteers who generously stepped up to help feed those in desperate need in Ukraine. Governor Reynolds' inspiration to package meals for those in Cherkasy and others affected by the senseless war in Ukraine is what led us to this event today. As you may have heard recently, it's been reported as many as 5 million Ukrainians have fled the country. This is about equivalent to the states of Nebraska and Iowa having their people flee those states. Not to mention the people in the country of Ukraine who are right now impacted by the ability not to have their basic needs met. At Meals from the Heartland, our sole purpose is to feed those in need here in Iowa, across the U.S., and around the world. Whether it's donating meals to local pantries, helping feed 500,000 kids a week through our mission partner Convoy of Hope, or providing relief to those affected by disasters, we freely give to those in need. As of last week, since 2008, we have distributed over 190 meals to people in need around the world. After this war began, many Iowans started asking if we would be sending relief meals to people in Ukraine. Our initial answer was we weren't sure how it could happen, but we're hoping we could find a way. So there's two major obstacles to sending aid to Ukraine. First, how do you logistically get the food where it needs to go in a timely manner? And second, how do we raise the money needed to purchase the ingredients, since this was not a budgeted item in our budget this year? Fortunately, prayers were answered when Governor Reynolds and her staff were able to arrange for the air cargo freight of 24 pallets through the Ukrainian consulate in Chicago. I'm also happy to announce that Fort Dodge-based Decker Trucking will be transporting the meals at their expense, free of charge, to Chicago next week, where they'll be flown into Poland and then into Ukraine on May 7th. Thank you, Bill. The next obstacle we faced was funding. How do we raise $50,000 to pay for the ingredients needed to package these meals? It came as no surprise when I found out that Heidi had stepped up and donated the $50,000. Heidi's been one of our largest supporters since 2011, and as Randy said, they've helped us package over 16 million meals, but they're also one of the most philanthropic companies in Iowa. This gift allows us to bless Ukrainians by sending almost 300,000 meals to them as relief. Additionally, as the governor said, Heidi graciously offered this conference space, the Juan Pearson Center, for us to package these meals. This allows hundreds of Iowans to come together and unite for Ukraine. This is what Iowans are all about. We are more than just Iowa nice. We are an unselfish, caring community that comes together and helps make a difference to support those who are hurting and in need. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg. I volunteered at several packaging events over the years, even times with my grandchildren, and I'm looking forward to volunteering again today during the next shift with my team that's here from Team Capital. So we're excited to get in there and package a bunch of meals for Ukraine. So thank you for your partnership with us and for everything that you're doing to provide ongoing support to Ukraine during this critical time of need. So each box being packaged today holds 36 bags of food and a little something extra that's also needed during this difficult time. When the last bag is added to the box, a short note with a message of encouragement is placed inside before it's taped up and ready to ship. You know, Greg suggested this as we were planning details for the event. And then last week, as my team was finalizing shipping logistics, the NGO that we've been working with to ship the food suggested it as well, sharing that people in Ukraine who've endured ongoing attacks for weeks, they need to be reminded that they're not alone in all of this, that people around the world do care and have not forgotten about them, and these notes will help give them a little hope as well. So to our friends in Ukraine, we're sending much love and hope from Iowa, and it's coming soon. As you heard, early next week, 24 pallets containing more than 1,300 boxes of food will be transported to Chicago, free of charge, thanks to the generosity of Decker Trucking in Fort Dodge. Again, Dale, thanks for being with us. We appreciate you helping us get it there as well. And within days, the meals will be flown overseas and then delivered to the regions in Ukraine, including Cherkasy. And that's really important because we have containers going over by ship, but it just takes a lot longer, of course, to utilize that method. So to be able to transport them by air, we're getting them there quicker. And so I'm really happy that we'll be able to do that. Today, with Iowa Sister States, my team is working closely with Cherkasy officials, the Ukrainian consulate in Chicago, an NGO who is specializing in transportation logistics. That has been a great partnership to all working together to deliver humanitarian aid to Ukraine. Every step of the process is fully funded through donations, and the state is not incurring any direct expense to provide this aid. The outpouring of support has been remarkable. I think you'll see that all day. We had the room filled last night, so it was exciting to see people, a lot of legislators and a lot of our agencies were here last night, as well as ID employees, boxing meals. But we've seen an outpouring of support from across the state, and just we've seen some heartwarming stories about communities. Churches and families are stepping up to collect donations to support Ukraine in a variety of ways. In Newton, a Ukrainian-born mother and daughters, Betha Miller and Maria Dobokin, collected tourniquets and badges and other first aid supplies to help soldiers on the front line. In Albion, Kathy Sebring, whose husband, Gordy, runs a farm in Ukraine, collected food, clothes, medical supplies, and more, filling two semi-trailers. And Encore Salon of Dubuque recently held a fundraiser to help Laura Yoder, who is a Ukrainian woman who works in the salon's building, and she's trying to get her daughter-in-law and grandson, currently refugees in Poland, to Iowa. So as you heard, Iowa Nice is just something that comes naturally to the people of our state, and it extends far beyond our borders. So there are many ways that you can get involved and many good causes to support. Meals from the Heartland is one of them, and it relies entirely on volunteers and donations to not only purchase but pack and ship meals worldwide, including to Ukraine. So if you're interested in more information about how to volunteer or donate, please go to mealsfromtheheartland.org. And with that, we'll go ahead and open it up for questions on topic, and then I'll do a gaggle afterwards for questions off topic. Anybody have any questions?
What specific foods are you sending to them?
So we're going to send our Taco Mac and our Hearty Pack meals. Taco Mac is a taco flavored mac and cheese that's fortified with vitamins and soy protein. And then our Hearty Pack is a rice based meal that has vitamins and soy protein and dehydrated vegetables in it. So, all in, it'll be about 47,000 food packets that we'll be able to hand out to the people of Ukraine.
It's about half and half.
Yep.
Is that right?
Half and half.
Okay, well, after the gaggle, we're expecting to take the turn and table to the media up there. You jump right in there and help us package meals, okay? Thank you for being here. We appreciate it very much. Thanks.